schon mal eins, die Frau Riecher. An den Tauben hier warten wir jetzt noch. Wir begrüßen aus Deutschland Hanji. Und aus Singapur kommt Tanui.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the GAC Group 2015 ITTF World Tour. We're at the Austrian Open, a major series on the World Tour. I'm Adam Bobro, and we are coming in to the second televised women's singles quarterfinals tournament being held in the beautiful and quaint Wels, Austria. Right now we've got defender Han Ying from Germany versus Singapore's Feng Tianwei, who's been the pride of Singapore for quite some time. Now, Feng Tianwei has been one of the top five players in the world on the women's rankings for a long time, only recently dipped out of the top five, is currently world ranked number seven. She's the third seed in this tournament and in the race to Lisbon for the World Tour Grand Finals coming up in December of this year in Lisbon, Portugal. She's the number seven seed in that race. She's 29 years old, just had a birthday a few days ago. I asked her what she did for her birthday. I said, it's your birthday today or tomorrow? What are you doing? She said, well, it's today. I had a sandwich. So she's very focused on the tournament, had a birthday sandwich, even sending the message on WeChat, delivered birthday cakes, but not for Feng Tianwei, not taking in the sugar right now, staying focused and practiced. Now, against defenders, talked about how Feng Tianwei's had some trouble. Historically, it's not one of her strengths. Han Ying, one of the top choppers in the game, currently world ranked number 11th, just moved up after last month being 12 in the world. She won the Korea Open last year and has been one of the top 10 defenders in the world on and off, using short pips on the backhand, a little bit more common within the Asian defensive game. The short pips don't make it quite as easy to get the ball back effortlessly from far from the table, but you're able to vary the spin and control the spin a little bit more, which leads to shorter rallies anyway, and it's also better for punching the ball, attacking from the backhand side. So Han Ying's been working on her spin variation for sure. Took a little time off the world tour. Has come back. Feng Tianwei, you can see some of her accomplishments here. The Olympics Games bronze medal. Not many people can say that, 2012. We've got the bronze medalist for the men, Dmitry Ovcharov, here at this tournament as well. The World Championships doubles bronze earlier this year in Suzhou, China. Now, Feng Tianwei, one of few players currently not playing for China, who's a serious threat to many of the Chinese players. In the Asian Games, the Asian Cup, was able to take down several Chinese players to win that just this year. Han Ying, you can see, even more experienced at 31 years of age, at least by age. World ranking from just last month on screen has moved up to number 11 now. Fifth seed in this tournament. So Han Ying has a 3-0 record against Feng Tianwei. There's coach of Feng Tianwei, Coach Jing Junhong. Has been with the Singaporean team for quite some time now. Over the years, you've seen her head umpire, Attila Petavari from Hungary. Assistant umpire, Kimie Akutsu from Japan. There was a controversial match. There's been a lot of controversy here as far as I think the umpires have been a little bit more strict on the rules. And it's an interesting question. That's their job, to call illegal serves when they see them. But there have probably been more service faults in this tournament than most players are used to seeing. We'll see if any come out here in this best of seven singles match. Feng Tianwei quick right into the body, takes the first point. Feng Tianwei with such touch, leaving it short on the forehand side for almost two bounces. Fast forward from Han Ying saved it, but then the follow-up ball, smart play, deep into the backhand corner. Go. the racket speed. Feng Tianwei with the first shot, quite impressive. Next shot, still a lot of racket speed, but plays it a little bit more patiently. See at the top of the screen there, Yuka Ishigaki for a moment, practicing her chops. Loaded from over the table on the forehand side. You'll even see some defenders twiddle the racket when they come in for a push to receive it with the inverted to get a lot of spin on the ball. So much work for a point. Feng Tianwei taking three right off the bounce, moving him around from on the body to wide to the forehand, then the backhand. The timing has to be just right. These shots so difficult, catching the ball still on the rise. And it's a quick point for Han Ying. Rare short rally. Top of the net and just off. Now, as far as Feng Tianwei having trouble against defenders, in this tournament, she started off against Polina Mikhailova, the Russian defender who had great success last week, pulling off many upsets in the Czech Open, and then played Irena Ivanchan, German chopper. Looked like it caught the edge of the racket there. Ball biting the table, staying low. Brought up the different choppers and defenders that Feng Tianwei's played before getting here, so she's had a strong warm-up, already beaten two defensive players. But Han Ying, the top of the class. Well placed, right on the body. Forcing Han Ying to stand up a little bit, pop the ball up higher. See that shot right in at the elbow, forcing her to take a ball a little uncomfortable. Again, a lot of factors to consider in every single shot, not only what's coming at you, but what you're gonna hit to your opponent and how it's gonna set up your follow-up shot. Feng Tianwei very smart with her placement. A little bit late, the 1 foot backhand punch attempt from Han Ying. My goodness, after such a rally, the inside out forehand, and Feng Tianwei wants none of that last shot. Could see her blowing it away with her hand, working so hard throughout this rally. Side spins coming at her, strong footwork. Says, why not come over the top, go through that ball? Shot's getting flatter and flatter as she earns a higher attack. Quite experienced Feng Tianwei. Again, all these players seeing millions of shots coming at them with different rotations. Really practice more than anybody. It's their profession to be as good as possible. But Feng Tianwei's experience seems unrivaled at this tournament. Wide angle, beautiful from deep into the forehand court, hits it even wider cross court. Clever shots inside out. Feng Tianwei really mixing it up. And mixing it up is the name of the game against any player. But against defenders, I feel like it pulls a different form of strategy and forces the attacker to really think about what they're gonna do to break the rhythm. I mean, Feng Tianwei has to change her game completely against a defender. Backhand punch shot for the winner cross court. Han Ying looking a lot more comfortable and decisive with that shot than the last time she took it on one foot. Looked like about an 80% shot for Han Ying. Nothing too ambitious, just a clean, good opportunity to attack and put it away. Looks like there's a little bit more on it. Han Ying a little bit short on the chop, and it's 4 game points for Feng Tianwei to take the first game in this best of seven. Change of stroke, a little bit shorter across the body, and Feng Tianwei varies it for an 11-6 victory in game one. We'll see if on paper, it's not an upset, but Feng Tianwei would have her first win in this match if she can take it. We'll see if it continues in game two. And as time is called, we're back for game two. Feng Tianwei starting off the match strong, taking the first game 11-6 over Han Ying. Now, Feng Tianwei is known to be a quite consistent player in general. Against attackers, her block game and her off-the-bounce speed and redirection, quite impressive. Break off the back edge of the table. Lucky shot for Han Ying. Will say, though, coming into that shot, it came back quite flat. Touches it just a bit differently. Doesn't really follow through on that ball, so it's going to be a floater. Part of the reason it came back so fast, but Feng Tianwei hit a hard shot at her, forcing that awkward shot to come back. It's a rare occasion. Feng Tianwei finishing the point early. Not with a powerful shot, but just a very well-placed shot on the body. Stop. Backhand punch and the saw from Han Ying. It looked even more effortless. The first backhand attack we saw was a bit off balance. Second one good enough to win the point, and the third one just looked like butter for Han Ying. Gets the elbow out, snaps through with the wrist. This time the short side of the table looked attractive to Feng Tianwei, but that's a high-risk shot. She knows it, tries to get back and cover the middle. Just a bit behind, a step behind. Gotta love how Feng Tianwei can take that forehand, step all the way around, come back and take a shot with the backhand, jumping right off the bounce to start that point. I mean, she really coast to coast, corner to corner with those forehand attacks. Two inside out forehands. The beauty of that, again, if that ball lands deep on the table, Feng Tianwei is fearlessly going for the attack off the bounce. Even though the ball missed, you saw the swing. It's another difference between professional and simply tournament level players. Every shot they're ready for, it seems. Stop. There's going to be less rotation on the ball after you've left it up on the table. Feng Tianwei leaves it short. Han Ying comes running back in. So basically all the top spin coming back is backspin from your loop. Just not going to be on the ball. From the middle to the middle, Feng Tianwei overshoots. And the miss hit. Another thing that's quite common against defenders is miss hits. At this level, the players, of course, fighter pilot eyesight out here. So they see the rotation well and they tend to time it just right. Depending on how much spin is on the ball will bite the table differently, stay closer to the net. At other times it's floating, it'll come a little bit deeper. Patient play, Feng Tianwei working very hard for that point. Han Ying even harder, just outlasts Feng Tianwei. When she softened up the ball and changed the pace, Feng Tianwei was able to slow it down a bit too. The timing to take that shot was just right. Feng Tianwei had Han Ying near the table, wanted to put the pressure on. Because Han Ying kept it low and deep, the pressure was on Feng Tianwei. Rare that you'll see the player catch the ball. Both players agreed it was a let. The umpires caught on a moment later. Powerful shot right into the body. Without that real follow through, it's gonna be difficult for Han Ying to hit a flat, sort of light underspin ball back. She did it before, it's pretty impressive. It's just a less consistent, higher risk shot. Smart play, again the placement. Feng Tianwei waiting till the last moment to come around the outside of the ball and play it to the short side of the table. From where she's standing from her footwork, it doesn't give complete clues to Han Ying as to where she's gonna go. So she tries to hide the shoulders, not turn too early. Not giving Han Ying any chance to make her move to cover that side of the table. Backhand punch shot with the short pips has less rotation. Comes in flat, and Feng Tianwei counters into the net. So with the second towel break, Feng Tianwei is making sure she's got traction on the bottom of her shoes for her footwork, which she's clearly using a lot of out here. There it is again. Bit of power and speed. Ball comes back flat off the short pib side from Han Ying. Choice shot right here. Heavy spin ball stays low, deep on the table. And that one changes the placement, a little bit more pace on it. Back edge of the table and the apology from Feng Tianwei. It's tied up at 7 points each. Watching the service toss rather, it's quite interesting to see the angle of the toss. This tournament, again, the service rules have been a little bit more strictly enforced. A lot of calls for tosses being back into the body. And Han Ying posing a different threat here, standing on the backhand corner, waiting to turn for the forehand counterattack. Can really change up the mentality of the attacker on the other side. Really like a dance out here, just beautiful choreography from both sides. For the rally to continue as long as it does, both of these players are being pushed to the limits. Loaded with spin deep on the table. It's difficult when it's deep on the table to leave it short, still keep it low to the net. much like a drop shot against a lob or a fishing shot. Oh, the outstanding counter from the forehand side, but when it's left short, Feng Tianwei on her tippy toes can't put it away, goes for the aggressive shot still. Crowd pleasing point. Way too high. This one right here, can't believe that one came back. By the time she got to that ball, the window had almost shut. And now it's 3 game points for Han Ying to tie it up. Two spinny backhands to start it off, a flat hit, and then one goes long. It's 11 points to 7. Han Ying of Germany ties it up at 1 game each. We'll be back to see who takes the lead in game 3 just after this short break. And the players are back for game 3. It's tied up at 1 game each. Feng Tianwei on screen right now, having lost the last game, 11 points to 7. Does not want this to be close. She's lost every battle they've had so far, and the last time it was a 7-gamer as well. Excellent placement, hard shot right down the middle of the table. Feng Tianwei being a bit more consistent with not only the slower shots, but even the high percentage ones. Again, Han Ying, one of the top defenders in the world for women right now. Deep on the table, sneaks under Han Ying's racket. Seemed like she wasn't happy with how she set herself up for that. Again, what we see is the winning shot, but what the player sees often is the ball that set them up, the quality of the shot before. Difficult shot, way out in front, tough to lift. Now, Feng Tianwei does not have the wingspan that Sofia Polkanova has. Experience, yes, Feng Tianwei has more than almost any woman in the game here at this tournament. Again, Feng Tianwei, the 3rd seed, Han Ying, the 5th. Little break off the top of the net, and the apology for Feng Tianwei. From Feng Tianwei, rather. Slow spinny shot from the middle there. Feng Tianwei changing the pace up, leaving it down low out in front of Han Ying. Now a little bit heavier spin, and Han Ying just a step behind the table. Sort of has her hands in the air right now. Feels like she's not finding any solutions at the moment. Last time they played, it was 4-3. That was the Qatar Open in February of this year, 2015. Well placed, puts a little bit of power on it, takes a little spin off. Feng Tianwei with the high risk kill shot for the win. See how much he has to get under that from the baseline of the table, but still touch it softly so that it doesn't fly off the table. And that's the last ball. Low to the net instead of the spinny ones before that were arcing up. Just missing the back edge of the table. And Feng Tianwei really exploiting the loose ends right now from Han Ying. Han Ying's gonna try to play her game a little closer to the table, as you've seen from the start of this game. Just so she can do that, turn on it and put it away with an inside-out forehand. Again, either side, she's got short pips on the backhand, so she's comfortable to punch it, as you've seen throughout this match. But that ball right there turns, looks like she's going down the forehand line. Feng Tianwei comfortable on both sides. A recovery shot, she was sent way out wide to the forehand, gets right back in with the backhand push. And it's much more difficult, especially against a defensive player, to keep some of these heavy rotating backspin shots on the table while you're moving and out of position. Feng Tianwei made it look like a walk in the park. Steady play from Feng Tianwei, half long to the forehand on the serve to start it off. It's an interesting idea, but a difficult shot. A block seemed a little bit like a half attempt from Han Ying. And now it's 8 game points for Feng Tianwei. And that's it, quick and painless, 11-2. Feng Tianwei dominates game 3. We'll see if she can continue and do her first unthinkable win over Han Ying. Game 4 just after this. And a let serve to start off game 4. Feng Tianwei starting with the serve, leading 2-1 over Han Ying, the defender at the top of the screen. Break off the top of the net, and it stays right up against the net. Nice and cozy for the point. Feng Tianwei with the apology for the lucky break. Change of pace and placement from Han Ying. Throws a little bit of a different rhythm over to Feng Tianwei's side. Testing her to see if she can make the soft shots against a slower but still heavy spin chops. Just missing wide on the line. Just wide of the line, rather, but the flat hit into the body successful for Feng Tianwei. Again, Feng Tianwei coming off of a win, 11 points to 2 in the last game. Should give her some confidence. She can continue this consistent aggressive play. I'd say judiciously aggressive. Quite difficult to see the difference from where we're sitting and on the court as well, but Han Ying getting a lot of racket speed, especially on the forehand chops, but with most of her backhands throughout that rally. Sometimes she changes the angle, the face of the racket just a little bit to float it back and vary the spin. That seemed like an opportunity for Feng Tianwei to go inside out. Normally, I think she would, but maybe because it was the more predictable shot, tried to play it down the middle again. Would see if Han Ying made her break to the backhand corner and then hit it behind her momentum, which is effective if you can make it. Just a little more difficult shot. Backhand going cross court from the middle out wide to the forehand just long. Coach Jeschep in the corner from Germany, defensive specialist. Clapping on, cheering on Han Ying. You see that eye contact from Han Ying. Very psychological. Soft hands to start it off. It's the backhand attack, a rare way to win a point against a defender, especially from Feng Tianwei. Shows great confidence again and understanding of the spin on the ball. Down the middle of the table again is trouble for Feng Tianwei. And these rallies are getting more and more challenging. Many big shots, counterattacks. You could see the short stroke, that was the topspin shot coming at Feng Tianwei. Rare from Han Ying to take one, a little bit spinnier on the forehand side. Like a service warning. Clever idea, looked like the ball was floating backlight underspin. Maybe looked a little bit heavier than Feng Tianwei thought. Overcompensated, opened the racket, it was too much. Popped it up high. The Japanese contingency cheering on Ai Fukuhara on the other side, the other quarterfinals. Big flat hit finds the edge of the racket and still almost comes down on the table. Feng Tianwei making it a 2-point game now. Just missing long. And there Han Ying turning into a Muppet for a moment. The body language just collapsing. Again, close game here. She's coming off of losing 2 points to 11. And has a 2-point lead, now just 1 point with her second serve. And this serve a little bit more typical. You see her twiddle the racket there to serve with the inverted rubber, control it, placement and spin. Beautiful shot right off the bounce, inside out. Feng Tianwei, the fist pump. She knows it's a high risk shot. Right off the bounce for the touch shot. Watch this follow up coming over the inside of the ball there, the top and inside. It looks like the timeout has been called at the second towel break. It's Coach Shep from Germany with Han Ying. Feng Tianwei seems so comfortable with almost anything that's being thrown at her. I think from a heavy chop standpoint, deep on the table, there've probably been more points from Han Ying on heavy chops than anything else. Now the backhand shot with the pips, the short pips attack, we haven't seen countered much. I think Coach Shep has noticed that as well. Seemed there was some instruction to get the backhand attack into play. And not the type of attack that we saw at the end of game three, the off-the-bounce block shot with the pips, but more of a punch shot when the ball's left a little bit high when she's in near the table. Again, this is why defenders, even though they're thought of to be quite far from the table, and they are farther than most, want to stay as close as possible as they can, still allowing them themselves to react and chop the ball back, but keeping the attacker honest and punching, finishing the point with an attack aggressively whenever they can. Tied up at 6 points each coming out of the timeout. Right now, Feng Tianwei could build a hotel on the middle of the table on the other side. She owns it completely. Shot after shot down the middle of the table. Han Ying just waiting for a mistake, trying to keep him deep on the table. Started the point near the table. No opportunity. Feng Tianwei earning that shot. Just missing wide. This is a run. 4 straight points for Feng Tianwei. It was down 4-6. I'm not a professional lip reader in many languages, so I'm not quite sure what Han Ying was saying, but I can't imagine it was a compliment to herself. There it is. Ouch, just spanked that ball. You could hear the slap sound so hard down the short side of the table. Feng Tianwei, normally I wouldn't point to her just for her head-to-head record against defenders, especially the top in the game. But if you want to study how to play a defender right now and last game especially, Feng Tianwei painting a perfect demonstration of how it's done. Patiently waiting for the opportunity to finish the point. And finally, an error from Feng Tianwei. A little glimpse into being a human. So many shots consistently here. Watch how she comes around the ball, changes her placement. That's the face I make when I hear the tips of a fork on a china plate. Feng Tianwei catching the edge of the racket creates a similar feeling, and now it's a timeout in Coach Jing's corner with Feng Tianwei. It's quite interesting, the facial expressions, the body language, sort of the tone that coaches have. It differs from coach to coach with their players. Get to talk with the players a lot about this. Coach Jing, especially kind and encouraging. And I think that's one of the most important things for players, quite frankly. I guess everyone responds differently. Some people need a little bit of a push or some tough love. But one thing they need to do is believe in themselves coming out on the court. Talking to Dmitry Ovcharov a bit. Jörg Roskopf, head coach of the German national team, also quite good at empowering his players. So tough to tell, but from the body language, there might be some conversation that just happened about sort of misleading, taking short adjustments on the stroke to try and get some, I guess, misdirection so that Han Ying's a little bit out of position to set up the follow-up attack. Feng Tianwei now with the serve at 9-7. Oh, the point was stopped. The game has been long enough. It's going to be expedite rule. The point does not count. Now this is an outstanding and awesome opportunity here to see something you might not have seen before. More commonly used defender versus defender, but the expedite rule is when 18 points have not yet been played in a single game and 10 minutes have passed. It is the umpire's job to call. This is not a point. The point had not yet been finished when it was called. Ball was still in play. So now there's going to be a third official who comes into the court and announces the defender's shot. And by defender, I don't mean Han Ying. I guess I should say the receiver. Whoever's receiving, if they can return the ball 13 times before the server can finish the point, the receiver wins the point. They will now alternate serves every point. This is not just for the remainder of this game, but for the remainder of the match. Now what this means is that Feng Tianwei is gonna have to finish the point, but when Han Ying is serving, she's gonna have to play more aggressively. And this can change the game in many ways. It can affect the psychology of even the attacker. The pressure should really feel like it's on the defender here because it's gonna change their game strategy a bit more. Two quick points. This is way out of character. Feng Tianwei has been in control ever since she made her comeback from down 4-6 to go up 8-4. And then as soon as expedite was introduced, two quick points went to Han Ying. My goodness, this has not been a good change for Feng Tianwei. Three of the fastest points of the match, and now it's a game point for Han Ying. Blessing in disguise out here. And a quick point. The points definitely are getting much quicker. Fortunate for Feng Tianwei. They just lost 3 points in a row from a 9-7 lead, and now we're at deuce. Just hearing someone calling the numbers can really change the psychology and change the pressure on the players. And this is the pressure. Feng Tianwei knows as the numbers are getting closer and closer to 13, she's gonna have to do something to finish the point. When you're used to playing so patiently and spinning back so many balls, to take a shot before it's there. Wow, stressful situation for Feng Tianwei. Flat hit goes up and out. Han Ying turns it around 12-10, and this game is becoming a thrilling and suspenseful match. Look at that, tied up. We'll see how things continue with the expedite rule in play for game five, coming back after this short break. So we're back for game five and things are just starting to get interesting. Expedite rule really shakes up the game here. You can see already the effect it's had drastically since 9-7 when Feng Tianwei had the 2-point lead at the end of last game again. The game before, Feng Tianwei won 11-2, and she just had the tables turned on her. Score flipped, not completely, but 12-10 at deuce, Han Ying came back. Break off the top of the net. I know when I'm in Feng Tianwei's position, part of me says, why couldn't that have happened last game at 1 point? Beautiful counterattack inside out from Han Ying. It's changing her strategies completely. It's like sometimes you don't know how tough you are until you're in a situation where you have no other choice but to be tough. Right now, Han Ying really puts, I guess it puts a lot of pressure on her to play a more aggressive game. Especially when she's serving. When she's defending, she can keep it on the table, chop all day long. It's gonna force Feng Tianwei to do something, to take a shot before the opportunity's there. A little bit of a float there. You can see she didn't cut under the ball as much. Wow. Really feeling for Feng Tianwei. Just had her birthday a few days ago. Had a strong lead, having never beaten Han Ying on a world tour. And is in trouble right now, deep water. And twist, this time the power shot comes through for Feng Tianwei, just a 2-point game. Now, of course, it's not all illusion. There is some pressure to finish the point, but it's very rare to see someone win the point on 13 returned shots. That's the fastest counting I've heard. Usually, when there's an expedite rule in play, there's not so much attack counter exchanges here. Several touch shots right there. So many topspin shots, and Han Ying staying close to the table again with the more aggressive play wins her the point. Very smart play. Feng Tianwei playing as aggressively as she can right off the bounce, keeping it deep to the forehand side. Han Ying not guessing. She has to lunge to get that one. In a good position to get the next ball back. Again, to go side to side, you have to plant your feet. You can't keep backing up at some point. It's just too difficult to move side to side. And a quick service point. Han Ying fired up right now. She's finding strategies she might not have even considered before the expedite rule. But she's winning points in all sorts of different ways now. Feng Tianwei play in the middle, back to the hotel. Look at this again, right into the body. You can see the hesitation, both shots making Han Ying weak in the knees. Big kill shot goes wide. Han Ying stays on top with a 3-point lead now. Again, they're tied up at 2 games each. Let me remind you once again, Feng Tianwei took a 2-1 lead, 11-2, before Han Ying tied it up last game when the expedite rule was introduced after being down 7-9. Smart play, brings her in short on the forehand side, hits it deep wide to the backhand. This is the combination play. Again, thinking in sequences. Feng Tianwei trying to keep that shoulder loose. It's a lot of work out there right now. Shoulder injury is one of the most common for the upper body in table tennis. One, two, three, four, five, real fight from Han Ying. You could see the eyes bug open there for a minute. Had to work. Several off the bounce shots, counterattacks here. The level of anticipation from Han Ying has really just reached new heights to really choose when she's going to attack it, not just move defensively, but move back into the table. Topspin on the table, deep in Feng Tianwei's shot. She tries to cover, but it goes up and out. It's also interesting to think how Han Ying really is thinking about when she is the receiver and when she is the server, because the strategies, the tactics from point to point change so drastically. And how many times we've seen services win the point since the expedite rule has been introduced. Han Ying has 5 game points. Deep on the table, fast and flat into the backhand side. 1 game point saved by Feng Tianwei. And the serving pattern continues as usual, even through deuce. Smart play right off the bounce. Han Ying had turned around, played it to the middle of the table instead of cross court or committing to the short side. And it left open a big hole on the forehand side of the table. Very smart, quick decision from Feng Tianwei. Again, reaction time, fighter pilots. Spinny backhand to start the point, and this is a bit of a run. It's 3 game points saved by Feng Tianwei, still shaking the arm to stay loose, keep the head cool. 2 points away from deuce. Again, they're tied in games. This could be the turning point of the match. Topspin serve, a quick point, and Feng Tianwei is 1 point away from making this a deuce game in the 5th. Comes back deep on the table, and what an escape for Han Ying right at the baseline, recovering. And it's Feng Tianwei left with the forehand over the table flip kill to tie it up, but she cannot do it. The pressure was there, and she's going to have to shake that off. Again, the mental game strong from Feng Tianwei, but the game's score not strong enough. 11-9, Han Ying takes it. We'll see if Han Ying finishes it in game 6 or if Feng Tianwei sends us to another deciding 7th game just after this short break. Don't go anywhere. And we're back for game 6. Feng Tianwei trailing 2-3 against Germany's Han Ying on the near side of the table in black. Again, the expedite rule in play. Receiver needs to get 13 balls back to win the point. That's an unusual way to do it. Let me rephrase that. The receiver does not need to get the ball back 13 times to win the point, but that's one other way that they can win the point that is not available when the expedite rule is not in play. Far from the table, Han Ying using the top spin to win the points, quite unusual. No! Smart play. Chop block comes around the side of the ball. Leaves it a little bit high. Gets a slower shot from Feng Tianwei. And Han Ying's right at the back of the table waiting to put it away with that punch shot. We'll see it. I believe it's the shot after this. There it is. A little bit of side spin on it. Slower ball. And she's there. Just punches through the ball. Cha. It was more of a saw. That's got to finish the point, and it does. Feng Tianwei gets a high ball to the forehand side to finish it. Again, the receiver, Feng Tianwei, can win it by looping it 13 times as well. Quite odd to see the attacker keeping it on the table that way, but that is how they got here to the expedite rule. Spin shot just sneaking under the racket of Feng Tianwei, catching the bottom edge, staying low. Seemed like a good opportunity for Feng Tianwei to block it back, counter it cross court. Step around, there it is, sees the opening. Just can't make the contact. Break off the top of the net, completely changing the rhythm, and it seems to get into the nerves of Feng Tianwei. Shaky hand, and the ball gets popped up high. Feng Tianwei doesn't have one of the most expressive faces in the game. Tough to tell if she's feeling the nerves right now. And a fighting Han Ying again on fire from the inside, filled with fury right now. Had her back against the ropes, lost the game 11-2, was down 1-2 in games, and right now has the advantage to finish the match in this game. Seems to be well on her way so far. Side. Ooh, Han Ying apologizing. I don't think that's good. She was way outside the table when she hit it. We'll see this again, although the umpires have no video review. Let's see. It looked like it went down to me. Your call. You can write all over the ITTF Facebook page. Little conversation. Assistant umpire agrees. Side of the table. Just because you apologize doesn't mean it's your point necessarily. The point before, Feng Tianwei got aggressive right early on, taking powerful shots early in the rally, trying to earn herself opportunities far before the count got high. It's the right idea. The time she takes to step around that ball, though, gives Han Ying a chance to get back into the backhand corner. It's a very difficult task to ask for a backhand attack from there. That might be necessary, though. And that's the highest we've seen the count. An outstanding rally again. Off the bounce, Feng Tianwei blocking everything back. You could even see Yu Mengyu clapping, surprised and smiling in the background. Heavy loops from Han Ying's forehand, right back in at the table. Almost falls to the ground, thought she had won that point. Still gets back up to keep it on the table. Just missing, has to go for broke on that last shot. The pressure to take it off the bounce with the backhand is there. Han Ying extends her lead again to a 5-point lead. I feel like the speed of the count is going with the hearts of everybody in the stadium right now. Heartbeats rising. And you have to wonder if this is a strategy here. I mean, what else would it really be but Feng Tianwei becoming a little bit more passive when she's the receiver blocking, testing Han Ying's forehand attack, letting her spin the ball, and then feel the pressure of the count getting high, and trying to put the ball away, taking too ambitious of a shot. Still down by four now with the serve. Edge of the table on the side. Strong rally though, Han Ying recovering from a few hard shots to the middle. Eye contact. Such a psychological game. That ball right there coming around the outside of it. A little bit of side spin to help carry it. Big point, Han Ying now. 6 match points over Feng Tianwei. Was looking like dark days early in this match for Han Ying. But now she's in a good position to repeat history and keep the match score 0 for Feng Tianwei. Several backhands in a row, but it's the top of the net and a dribbler over with the apology audible from Han Ying. 11-4, and thank you, Expedite Rule, for putting the pressure on me to play a completely different game. From long serves to varied spins to forehand and backhand attacks off the bounce, sure made the game interesting. And in favor of Han Ying, what a battle. Feng Tianwei struggles through. Close start to the match. But it's Han Ying of Germany, 4-2 over Feng Tianwei, who will be moving on to the women's singles semifinals. Again, what a match. Enjoy some highlights. We've got the men's singles quarterfinals coming up just after this. You don't want to miss it. Adrien Martinet of France, who had a thrilling point just last week in the Czech Open, 91 shots long against Pargarel. The defensive specialist from France is going to be playing Croatia's Andrej Gacina just next, so stay here for the men's singles quarterfinals.